Sorry for the interruption. So we are discussing about the comparison of the three learning rules, FBN learning, error correction learning, and competitive learning. This is a continuation from the previous video. So in learning rate, in error correction learning, we'll make use of random values between 0 and 1 for initializing the learning rate. And in competitive learning also, we use the value between 0 and 1 for initializing the learning rate. A FBN learning rule will not utilize the learning rate. Okay. So this is the last learning rule, the memory-based learning. We'll try to understand it with the help of some theoretical approach. What happens in memory-based learning is, if you look at the name, it is going to make use of memory. This rule, all the past experiences are stored in large memory of correctly classified input-output examples. That means, for every input xi, the desired response di is also known, and it is stored into the memory. Whenever user asks about the response of particular input vector xi, because the desired response is also available as a stored value, it will be directly given back to the user. Okay, so this is the formula for all the examples from I is equal to 1 to n. The tuple xi comma di, the pair xi comma di is stored into memory. That is why it is named as memory based learning. So the input and its response are stored and available in the memory. So whenever user asks for a particular input, the corresponding desired corresponding response will be directly given back to the user by collecting it from the memory. And all memory-based learning algorithms primarily involves two essential things. One is criteria, which criteria the memory-based learning algorithm is going to use to define the local neighborhood. That means to identify the value when the stored value is not available, and the learning rule applied to training examples in local neighborhood. Okay, how it actually identifies the local neighborhood of the examples. Okay, there are two approaches. One is nearest neighborhood approach. The local neighborhood is defined as the training example that lies in the immediate neighborhood of a particular vector. Let us say it is x test. That means a vector xj belonging to set x1, x2, so on, xn is to be the nearest neighbor of x test if the distance from xj comma x test is the minimum among all the distance of xi's to the x test. Okay, so this d of xj comma x test will be identified as the minimum Euclidean distance between all the input vectors xi to the corresponding x test, which is under testing. That means for which we are identifying the local neighborhood, nearest neighborhood. So any vector xi will be identified as the nearest neighborhood of x test if its Euclidean distance is the minimum among all the Euclidean distances of other xi's. Okay, so this is the first approach we'll use to identify the nearest neighborhood of a particular x test. And the second approach is k nearest neighbor classifier, in which k classified patterns that are nearest to the test vector x test are identified, and a majority voting is considered for identifying the local neighborhood, that is the nearest neighborhood of x test. Okay, so that means you need to understand this with the help of an example. Let us say this is x test, d is the x test, and the nearest values are 0, 1, and 1. Among these three, the majority vote goes to the classifier 1, therefore, the winner is 1. So for this x test, the nearest neighbor is identified as 1. Even though 0 is identified as 0 is the closest value to this D based on the majority voting. If K is equals to 3, 1 wins. Okay, the value that is closest to X test D is going to be 1. Okay, in case of nearest neighborhood or local neighborhood, it's going to be 0 only. But in K nearest neighbors, among all the closest values, the winner, that is based on the majority objects that is closer to the corresponding X test, winner will be selected. So in this example, 1 is the nearest neighborhood of D. Okay. So it is explained over here. The nearest neighbors 0, 1, 1 are considered for the X test, assuming D is a X test. Since 1 wins by voting 2, the test point D is classified as 1 only, but not as 0, even though 0 is the closest neighbor of D. Okay, so this approach is very much useful in classification problems for identifying the classification algorithms. Okay, so that is about memory based learning. In short, memory based learning is actually used when majority of the desired responses are known. The beginning itself, both the input vector and the desired response are stored into a large memory. If the desired responses are not known, then either we can use the nearest neighbor approach or k nearest neighbors approach to identify the corresponding response of the corresponding input vector. Okay, so that is about memory based learning. With this, we have completed all the learning rules from second unit. With this, we can stop the discussion about learning rules now. All of you please go, because these four learning rules are very important. All of you please revise all the learning rules properly. Practice all the examples given out there. And also, error correction learning, Hebbian learning, competitive learning. Please practice all the problems given out there. Okay. Thank you all for the patient listening. When we come back, we'll discuss about the state space trees and their applications in neural networks. And also another important topic, how optimization is useful while designing neural networks. With discussion on those two topics, second unit will be completed. Okay. See you in the next session. Thank you all.